Welcome, Super Church Online. I can't believe we've been doing Super Church Online for over 6 months now. 6 months! Hopefully soon we can start meeting here in person. You guys remember this room, right? Yeah? Well, until then, thank you for staying with us, for tuning in. This is the month of thankfulness. And we've been challenging you to be thankful for your family, thankful for your friends, thankful for the clothes that you have, for the house that you live in, just to learn to be thankful for everything. But also, don't forget, the most important thing to be thankful for, be thankful to God for all that He's done for you. Be thankful for sending Himself to earth to die on the cross for your sins. Man, someday we can meet and live with God in heaven someday. And that is something to be very thankful for. Well, thank you, and I want to thank you for just being a part of our church and being a part of our ministries here. Hopefully we can see you soon, and I can't believe that coming up this Saturday is, normally we would have our family fun night here at the church where all the kids would come over and we play lots of games and all those kinds of things. We're not going to be able to do that like we normally would, but we do have something else we have planned this Saturday. I'll let other people tell you a little bit more about it later on. But anyway, thank you so much for being with us, and enjoy Super Church.
I'm gonna sing, sing, sing. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout. I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout. Praise the Lord. When the gates are open wide, I'm gonna sit at Jesus' side. I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout. Praise the Lord. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout. I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, praise the Lord. When those gates are open wide, I'm gonna sit at Jesus' side. I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, praise the Lord. I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, praise the Lord.
This week on The Biggest Loser, we're going to be checking up on last month's contestant, Jason Castillo. But first, let's have a quick recap of last month's episode.
Introducing this month's contestant, Jason Castillo.
Hi, my name's Jason.
So Jason, can you tell us how much you weigh as of currently?
I weigh around...
Sorry, can you repeat that?
Be louder!
I weigh around 986 pounds.
Haha, so you heard them. Alrighty then, let's see if Jazel has what it takes to become the biggest loser.
Hi Jazel, how you feeling?
Pretty good. I'm slowly making healthier habits, so it doesn't matter how much I weigh right now. I'm content, I'm happy just the way I am, but making healthier decisions. I'm just gonna trust in the process, be patient, and continue on with what I'm doing.
There you have it, folks. Well, that's all we have for today. Tune in next time to see who has what it takes to become the biggest loser.
It's game time. Zoom out. Guess the picture. If you guess it right in the red zone, you get 5 points. If you guess it right in the orange zone, you get 3 points. If you guess it right in the green zone, you only get 1 point. Ready, set, go! What could this be? Any guesses? Oh, orange zone now. I think I know what it is. Ooh, I really know what it is now. I hope you know it too. Time's up. They're pumpkins. Thanks for playing.
Jude 22. And some have compassion of making a difference. Jude 22.
Jude 22. And of some having compassion making a difference.
Give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Psalm 136, verse 1.
Psalms 136, verse 1. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good.
Psalm 136. Give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good.
Psalms 136, verse 1. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good.
All right, guys, it is time for our memory verse for this week. And once again, this is a very short verse, so you won't have any problem memorizing this one at all. And it is found in John 6:47, and it says, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me shall have everlasting life." So that was the first time. Okay, so now this time, read it out loud with me. "Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me shall have everlasting life." And before we even start memorizing this, I just want to tell you guys why this verse is so cool and why it's so important. And this verse is talking about, the one talking in this verse is Jesus Christ. And he's saying that if you believe on him, if you believe in Jesus, you too can have eternal life. And this is the whole purpose of why we're doing this junior church online still, even though through this whole COVID pandemic, while we're still filming these videos, is so that hopefully that some children will be able to believe in Jesus Christ so that others can also have everlasting life. So this is a very, very powerful verse, and there's a great promise in this one little short verse. But now let's try memorizing it out together. Okay, so the verse goes, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me shall have everlasting life." Now, this might be too hard for some of you, but let's try saying the verse out loud, but let's cover our eyes, all right? And no cheating. I can see you guys through my hands, all right? So let's say the verse out loud together without looking at the screen, and let's cover our eyes, okay? Ready, set, go. "Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me hath everlasting life." So hopefully you guys did that as well. But if you couldn't do it at first time, pause the video, rewind, and try to get it the next time, right? So make sure you guys are able to memorize this memory verse for the week. And I'll see you guys next week, or next time.
Let everything that God made say thank you, Lord. Let everything that God made say thank you, Lord. Let everything that God made say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for making me. The monkeys in the jungle say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Woo, woo, woo. The monkeys in the jungle say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Woo, woo, woo. The monkeys in the jungle say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Woo, woo, woo. Thank you, Lord, for making me. Oh, let everything that God made say thank you, Lord. Let everything that God made say thank you, Lord. Let everything that God made say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for making me. The bears in the woods say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Rah, rah, rah. The bears in the woods say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Rah, rah, rah. The bears in the woods say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Rah, rah, rah. Thank you, Lord, for making me. Oh, let everything that God may say, thank you, Lord. Let everything that God may say, thank you, Lord. Let everything that God may say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for making me. The gators in the swamp say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Chomp, chomp, chomp. The gators in the swamp say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Chomp, chomp, chomp. The gators in the swamp say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Chomp, chomp, chomp. Thank you, Lord, for making me. Oh, let everything that God may say, thank you, Lord. Let everything that God may say, thank you, Lord. Let everything that God may say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for making me.
That you all have your Bibles by now, but if you don't, you can go ahead and grab it. And while you're grabbing it, I have a question for you guys. What is the longest time that you've ever slept? What is the longest time that you've ever slept? And for the average person, just so you know, it's about 8 hours of sleep, at least for adults. And I think for me, the longest time I've ever slept was maybe 15 to 17 hours. I don't really remember, but I think it was that one time that when my family traveled from the Philippines all the way back to Canada. And the reason why I slept so long was because I was so tired, and being on a plane for so long also gets you really tired, and also because the time zones were different. But anyways, today we're actually going to learn about somebody in the Bible who slept for a very long time. And they didn't sleep for 17 hours. They didn't sleep for even a day. They slept for 4 days straight. 4 days straight. Isn't that crazy? But anyways, if you have your Bible, please turn to John chapter 11. And we're going to read starting from verse 1. And it says, "Now a certain man was sick named Lazarus of Bethany, the town of Mary and her sister Martha. And it was that Mary which anointed the Lord with ointment and wiped his feet with her hair, whose brother Lazarus was sick. Therefore his sister sent unto him, saying, Lord, behold, he whom thou lovest is sick. And when Jesus heard that, he said, This sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God might be glorified thereby." All right, before we move on, we're going to pray. Lord, thank you so much for today and for giving me this opportunity to teach. I pray, Lord, that you please give me wisdom and you would show me, Lord, just what it is that you would have me to say. And I pray for the kids that you help them to be good listeners and to also learn something today. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. All right, so for our story today, we're actually learning about three different characters. Okay, and they're all siblings and their names are Mary, Martha, and Lazarus. Mary, Martha, and Lazarus. And in verse 1, it tells us right away that Lazarus, the brother from these siblings, he was very sick. And before we move on, I just want to let you know that Mary, Martha, and Lazarus, they were really close friends with Jesus, and Jesus loved them very, very much. But Lazarus, as I said, he was very sick. And even though he had his sisters there to take care of him, no matter what they did, Lazarus was just not getting any better. And so what they did was they called somebody from their town, or they found one of their friends, and they told their friends to go to Jesus, who was in a nearby town at that time, and to tell Jesus to come there to where they're living, and they were living in a place called Bethany. They told this person to tell Jesus to come to Bethany to go and heal Lazarus, because Lazarus was sick. And so this person, they go to Jerusalem where Jesus was, and they tell Jesus about Lazarus and how he needed to be healed because he was very sick. But something different and interesting about this was that Jesus, he actually didn't go with this person. Even though he heard the sad news that his own friend Lazarus was sick,
Jesus actually didn't go to Bethany and heal him. And you might be wondering and saying, huh? Why would Jesus not go all the way to Bethany? Why would he not go and heal Lazarus? I thought that Jesus loved him and that he was his friend. Why would he not go and heal him? Well, you see, when Jesus found out that Lazarus was sick, Jesus had something else in mind. Jesus had planned something even more wonderful than just healing Lazarus from his sickness. What I want you guys to take away from this is that sometimes in our lives, we find ourselves in a very similar situation. Sometimes we think to ourselves, how come Jesus, or why did God take away my friends from me? Why am I having such a hard time at school and I can't understand anything? Or how come I'm not doing so well with my grades? Or how come Jesus is allowing these people to be mean to me when I'm being so nice to them? How come life is just so hard? And you might be wondering all of these things, and you might be saying, Lord, how come you're allowing these things to happen to me? Don't you care about me? Don't you love me? Well, the thing is, yes, Jesus does love you, but sometimes God has to take away things from us, or sometimes God has to take people away from us, or he allows these unexpected and hard things to happen to us because he has something better in plan. And today in our story, we're going to see how Jesus had something even better in plan than whatever Mary and Martha had in plan. But anyways, back to the story. While Mary and Martha, they were probably at home, they were waiting for this messenger person and also Jesus to come back and heal Lazarus. But while they were waiting and waiting, Jesus, like I said, he didn't come. And as they were waiting, Lazarus was actually getting sicker and sicker. And sadly, Lazarus actually passed away. Lazarus died. And Mary and Martha, when this happened, they were probably so confused and they were saying, where was Jesus all of this time? How come he didn't come to help her brother? Doesn't he care? And since Lazarus passed away, they had to go and bury him. And so what they did was Mary and Martha's neighbors and their friends, they came over and they mourned and they cried with Mary and Martha. But at the same time, they wrapped him in clean cloths and then they put him in this cave and then they blocked this cave with a stone. And so that's where they put Lazarus when he died. But after this, Mary and Martha, they went back home and they just kept saying, oh, if only Jesus had come, then our brother would still be alive today. But while all of this was happening, do you guys think that Jesus actually didn't care? Do you guys think that Jesus actually didn't know that Lazarus died? Or maybe that Jesus was just ignoring them? No, right? I don't think Jesus didn't know. In fact, Jesus actually knew that Lazarus died, even though nobody told him. And we know this because he, I think 2 days after the messenger person came, Jesus was telling his disciples, hey, let's go back to Bethany. Let's go to this place called Bethany and we're going to go visit my friend Lazarus because he passed away. We need to go there right now. And so Jesus, he did know and he did care, but he remembered, like I said earlier, that Jesus had something else in mind. And so Mary and Martha, they were still at home. They were still crying and wondering why Jesus didn't come. But Jesus and his disciples, they finally made their way to Bethany. And it tells us here in the Bible, in verse 17, that Jesus and his disciples, they finally come to Bethany. But Lazarus was already dead for 4 days. And you might be wondering, huh? Why would Jesus wait all that time? Why would he go 4 days after Lazarus is already dead to go and visit him? Well, like I said, Jesus had a different plan. But anyways, Martha, she finds out that Jesus is in town. And so what she does is she goes and she runs and she finds Jesus and she tells him. And we see this in verse 21. She says, Lord, if thou hadst been here, my brother had not died. She was saying, Lord, if you had just come a little bit earlier and healed my brother, then he would still be alive today. But Jesus says and tells her in verse 23, he says, thy brother shall rise again. And so Jesus was saying, don't worry, Martha, your brother's going to be alive again. Martha said, yeah, I know that Lazarus is going to come back to life again when we all go to heaven. He's going to be alive again. But this was not what Jesus meant. Jesus actually meant that he was going to bring Lazarus back to life. He says in verse 25, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? And Martha, she still thought that Jesus was still talking about something else. And so she goes and she runs and goes to her sister Mary. She goes to their house where Mary was, and Mary was there. She was still crying about Lazarus being dead. And so Martha tells her, hey Mary, Jesus is here. He's in town and he wants to see you. And so Mary, she wipes her tears away. She goes and she runs to Jesus because she also wants to see him. And the interesting thing here is that the moment Mary finds Jesus, she says the exact same thing as her sister. And she says, Lord, if thou hadst been here, my brother had not died. She was saying, Lord, if you were here earlier, then my brother would still be alive today. And of course, Jesus did care about what Mary and Martha were feeling. But remember, Jesus had something else planned. And so Jesus, the moment he sees Mary, she says, hey Mary, where did you lay Lazarus? Where is his grave? Where is his cave or his tombstone? And so the moment they got to the tombstone or the cave where Lazarus was laying, Jesus, he cried. And at the same time, he tells Martha and Mary, he says, hey, I want you to take the stone away. He says, take ye away the stone. And Martha, the moment she heard this, she was like, huh? Why would you want to open that stone? And the reason why she said this was because in verse 39, she says, Lord, by this time he stinketh. He had been dead 4 days. She was saying, Lord, if we're going to open that tombstone, if we're going to open that cave, it's gonna smell so bad because Lazarus has been dead for 4 days. But anyways, Jesus says, hey, just believe me. And so what happens is the people there, they remove that stone away, and I'm pretty sure it did smell a little bit, or a lot actually. But anyways, the moment the stone was rolled away, Jesus looked up into the sky and he prayed and he thanked God. And then he said 3 words after this. And it says here that he actually cried with a loud voice. And he said, Lazarus, come forth. He said, Lazarus, come forth. He says, Lazarus, come out. Jesus was literally telling Lazarus to come back to life. And so the moment he said this, it was probably like in those intense movies. And he was just standing there waiting. And suddenly in verse 44, it says, he that was dead came forth. Lazarus, he walked out of that cave. Lazarus, he came back to life. Jesus brought Lazarus back to life. And that day, many people who had never believed in Jesus changed their minds about him. They knew that only God could bring a dead man back to life. And can you imagine how happy Mary and Martha were to finally have their brother come back to life? And remember, Mary and Martha, they had all of those days waiting for Jesus to finally come and heal their brother. And they kept even saying, oh, if only Jesus was here, if only he came sooner, and if only he had healed our brother, then our brother would be alive. But you see, Jesus or God has his own timing with things. And sometimes God makes us wait so that we can rely on him. Kind of like what Miss Jaisal was saying with her fitness earlier. She was telling us how sometimes we can work really hard or we can eat very healthy, but we won't see the results right away, and we just need to be patient. And Jesus has the power, and he showed us during his entire lifetime here on earth that he was able to do anything and that nothing was impossible with God. And today we even learned that he brought somebody back to life. And although Jesus does not often bring people back to life here on earth, he does promise in the Bible in 2 Timothy 2:11 that we shall also live with him. And it also tells us in our memory verse in John 6, verse 47, it says, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me hath everlasting life." This means that whoever believes in Jesus and follows him will live with him in heaven one day, or after they die. They will live with Jesus one day. And so my question for you today is, do you believe in Jesus? Do you believe that Jesus died on the cross for you so that you can go to heaven one day and be with him? And have you ever asked Jesus to come into your heart and be your personal Lord and Savior? And have you ever repented of all your sins? And if that's you here today and you've never asked Jesus to come into your heart, or if you're not sure where you're going to go to after you die, whether you're going to go to hell or if you're going to heaven, if you've never prayed something like that, you can talk to your parents about it. You can talk to any of us leaders, you can give us a call, or you can send us an email, and we'd love to tell you more about it. But that's the best decision that you can make. And if you are here today and you are saved, my question for you is, do you still believe that Jesus can do miracles in your life today? And it doesn't have to be something big and supernatural. It can be something very simple, like helping you with a test at school. That's a miracle within itself. But do you still believe that Jesus can do miracles in your life today? All right, let's pray. Lord, I thank you so much for today. And I thank you, Lord, for the miracles that you've done. And Lord, I thank you for dying on the cross for us so that we can be with you in heaven someday. And I pray for the students here who are not so sure where they're going to go after they die. I pray, oh God, that they would get that settled and that they would get saved. And Lord, please be with us for the rest of the week. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
You know, you guys learned something really, really cool. Once again, Jesus did another miracle, and he raised this man, and his name is Lazarus. He raised him from the dead. And that is amazing. I can't do that. Obviously, when I got out of bed, I was not dead. I was just sleeping, so it was easy for me to do. But Jesus, he did something so miraculous, and he was able to do that. So today, I just wanted to remind you about this.
John 6:47, and it says, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me shall have everlasting life."
That's right. I want you to remember our memory verse for the day. And Brother Ivan already talked about it. So I want you to remember that. And also, I wanted you to think about these people.
Hi there. This is your missionary to London, England, Brother Ryan Strother.
Right. They are the Strother family, and they are in the United Kingdom. So if you guys don't know where that is, well, I'm just going to show you a few pictures from that place. And here they are. Isn't that so cool? So they are there and they are telling people about Jesus Christ. They're telling people about the resurrection of Jesus Christ, which you guys also learned earlier. And last but not the least, I want to challenge you guys to memorize our memory verse this week. And I believe, let me just check my notebook here, it is John chapter 6, verse 47. So all you have to do, and I know some of you already do this, so you just have to say the verse, you have to take a video of yourself saying the verse, and then you have to send it to us so I can see it. And it's super easy, right? So that's your challenge for this week. And before I say goodbye, I wanted to show you my video of me saying the memory verse. So let's go ahead and watch it. John chapter 6, verse 47. "Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me hath everlasting life."
Well, I tried my best, and I know that you guys will do even better than how I did earlier when I was saying that memory verse. But I hope that inspired you to say your memory verse as well, and that you can take a video of yourself and send it to us. So thank you again for joining us today, and I will see you guys again next time. Goodbye!